Goodreads and check what my reviews are. Okay. Hey guys, this is Jenny from Bookish Bedside, which I'm thinking of actually just changing it to my name, Jenny Lynn, but we'll see. Shall see. Hey guys, this is Jenny Lynn, and I am here to do a February wrap-up. As you can tell by my lack of videos, I have been MIA, but I'm back, and I have no excuse for me being gone for so long. I've just been spending time with my kids, coming home from work, being by myself while my husband works graveyard. It's a little tiring. It takes a lot out of you. So, but I have not been in a reading slump. I've just been on a uploading, editing type of slump. But I did read a lot of books in the month of February, so I guess we can say that this is my late February wrap-up. So, let's get started. I don't want this to take forever. So one of the first books I read was The Tale of Beetle the Bard by J.K. Rowling, which is one of the Harry Potter, you know. And I enjoyed it, but I mean, it was nice. It was just a nice read. A nice quick read. The next book I also was able to read was through my Kindle, and it was Naruto Volume 50. You guys, if you're gonna get into any sort of manga or anime, I absolutely, besides Rurouni Kenshin, I can't even say it, I love Naruto. Like, I've been watching this since I was in high school, so it's been a long time. And I'm barely in volume 50, I know. But yes, and next book I read is, well, I didn't read it. I listened to it through the audiobook, and it was Angel Fall by Susan E., which I love. I really liked it a lot. I gave it a 4 stars. So I gave the whole series as a whole 4 stars. So immediately after Angel Fall, I got World After on audio. And what was next? And I then went straight to End of Days. And as a whole again, 4 stars. So basically, this whole Angel Fall series by Susan E. is about a girl named Penryn, who is human, and Rafi, who is an angel who lost his wings, and they have to rely on each other. You know, Penryn doing everything she can, risking her life trying to find her sister, who was taken by the angels, and Rafi, who had his wings taken away from him, and he's trying to get back to where he came from, trying to become whole again. So, I've never read anything like that. I haven't read a lot of things. So, I was actually very interested, and it was very cheap on Kindle, and I guess just like a few more dollars, I was able to get it through audiobook. And so I thought, why not? So, after listening to it, I really did got into the plot line, and I was really invested in the characters, and I really wanted to know what was going on until the very end. And I have to say, as a whole, I give it about 4 stars out of 5, according to Goodreads. So I really liked the book. So the next book I was able to read was Stars Above by Marissa Myers, and this basically has 9 novellas. Some of them have already been written years ago, and there's some new ones in there too. Some I liked, some I didn't care much for, but it was just nice being back in the world of the Lunar Chronicles. And I was expecting the epilogue to be much bigger, but yet, even though it wasn't as big as I was hoping, it was still very satisfying. So I didn't give it any stars because, again, it's just a novella and I just enjoyed it. I would probably give it, if I had to, according to Goodreads, I would give it like 3.5 to 4 stars. So yes. So the next book I was able to read was Glass Sword by Victoria Aveyard, and I am so happy, but yeah, at the same time so sad, because now I have to wait for the next book now, and I guess that's not until next year. Am I even gonna live till next year? I don't know, but I need that book now. I need to know what's gonna happen. I mean, this book is completely different from Red Queen. Whereas Red Queen, it was about Mare being in high society and, you know, just figuring out who she is. And this book is basically everything after, and just her trying to become stronger. And just as the Red, just like the Red book, a Red Queen book, there's still a lot of deaths, a lot of, you know, betrayals, just a lot of feels. Just like the Red Queen, and it's very fast-paced. I love fast-paced, you guys, and full of action and subtle hints of romance. So yeah, there's some annoying stuff about Mare that I just want to just quit, but it's still good overall, and I give it 5 out of 5 stars. Because I just love the story. I just love it so much. The next book is Unhooked by Lisa Maxwell. And this is a standalone. And I think I give this a 3 out of 5 stars. I liked it. I didn't really like it, but I liked it enough to give it a 3 stars, according to Goodreads rating. And it's basically about two girls who are very close friends, one of them being Gwen, who gets taken to Neverland. And there they meet Captain Hook and Peter. And I have to say that this book is beautifully written. Just, it wasn't fast-paced enough for me. I felt like there should have been more action, more adventures. But the writing is just incredible. Where Neverland in Wendy Darling by Colleen Oakes, whereas that place is a little more playful, a little more like whimsical, I think. This Neverland is quite like the Neverland Island itself is still very beautiful, it's still very enticing, still full of adventures, but at the same time, it's very dark and menacing, scary, and you just don't know who's lying and who's telling the truth. And it's just, but it's good. And I just love the fact that this is a standalone and I do not have to wait for another book. Love it. So, 3 out of 5 stars. So the last book I was able to read in the month of February is These Vicious Masks by Tyrone Shanker and Kelly Zekas. So the reason why I pre-ordered this book was the line that caught me on Goodreads, and that was Jane Austen meets the X-Men, and it truly is Jane Austen meeting the X-Men. If you read Pride and Prejudice, you might have a similar feel of the whole Elizabeth Bennet and her sister Jane with Evelyn and Rose. Yes, Evelyn is Elizabeth, Rose has to be Jane. So this book is basically about two sisters by the name Evelyn and Rose, who have this knack of taking care of people. So in a way, on their spare time, they go and nurse the sick. So one day, Rose vanishes, and so Evelyn now goes on this adventure with this dashing Mr. Kent to England, by all means looking for her sister, and It's just a beautifully written book. The pacing is okay, because this is a similar pacing to Pride and Prejudice, or to any of Jane Austen's books. But when it gets to the middle, it picked up a little. But regardless, through the whole book, it was just, the way it was written, it was just beautiful. Like, there are many times I just laughed, because it was just, like, the conversations between certain characters and the way something is being described, it's just hilarious. And I love how lighthearted this book is during something that's going on that's serious. And then towards the end, you kind of get that whole X-Men feel too. So I do really like this book, and I totally give this a 4 out of 5 stars. And I really, really cannot wait for the second book. Cannot wait. So that is my February wrap-up, my very late February wrap-up. I'm going to hopefully edit and upload this tonight. I will see you guys on my next video. Hopefully it won't be next month. Hopefully it will be very soon, like next week. Bye.